friends. In this video, I'm sharing a packing list for a 5-day conference or business trip. We're gonna go over a few things that you need to consider before you put together your list, and then I'm gonna go over some clothing and miscellaneous items that you definitely need to pack. A few simple things to consider before you start packing. Number one, figure out how formal or casual the event is. Different industries have different standards of how people dress. If you're an attorney, you're probably gonna dress a bit different for a conference than if you're a telecom tech person. If it's a new conference for you, if you don't know anybody who's been before, or maybe it's a new industry or culture that you're breaking into, dig around on that conference's social media or their website to see if you can find photos of past events, past similar conference, and take a look at what people are wearing. What's the style? Is it pretty formal? Is it casual? Is it something in between? And then the other thing to consider is what's the weather gonna be like when you're visiting, even if the conference is in the same exact building all day long and the conference facility is connected to your hotel. You're probably gonna wanna go leave and explore the city or actually go get dinner somewhere. Now before you pack any of your clothing, make sure that you try it on and make sure that your outfits actually work together. Something you wore a few months ago in the summer might fit a bit differently in the winter. And also when you put something on, you can tell if it's fresh or it needs to be ironed or washed or something. For example, as I was packing for this conference, I was about to throw this top into my suitcase. It's kind of one of my classic go-tos. But when I put it on, I realized it stinks because apparently I hadn't washed it after a couple times of wearing it. And also, it's got these lovely sweat marks. I got sweat marks on my shirt. That's embarrassing to share on the internet, and I'm sharing with you so you don't make that mistake. So try on your clothes before you pack them. So what clothes do you pack? Bring one top for every day of the conference and maybe another one if you're staying an extra day. And that dress can count as a top since it's basically an outfit in one. For bottoms for a 5-day business or conference trip, you shouldn't need more than 2 pairs of pants or skirts. Having a pair of black pants is essential because you can mix it with basically anything. Try not to bring a pair of pants or skirt that you'll only wear once and that'll be super obvious if you wear it again. For example, a pair of blue pants. Honestly, I'm not a huge fan of slacks. Even though I own some pairs, I feel way more confident in a nice black pair of jeans. I'm not actually bringing slacks. I'm bringing a black pair of jeans and a gray pair of jeans, and I'm pairing those with nicer tops, so it's definitely a bit more of a casual vibe for me. You really shouldn't need more than 2 or 3 pairs of jackets. Depending on the weather, you should be able to mix and match enough outfits with 2 or 3 jackets and 2 pairs of jeans and 5 tops, so you don't have to bring 5 different jackets. But definitely bring at least one jacket or cardigan, just because conference centers tend to be a bit over-conditioned and chilly. As far as shoes go, I've heard the tip that you should be bringing a pair of mid-rise heels, a pair of flats, and a pair of more casual, comfortable shoes that you can wear to the conference. But I personally tend to bring more pairs of shoes than recommended just because I need that variety, otherwise I start getting blisters. I own some flats, but I've never been comfortable with them, so I rarely wear them, and I've never found a pair of flats that really work for me. So for this trip, I'm bringing 3 pairs of shoes for the conference, 2 pairs of little booties that I can mix and match, 1 pair of very low heels, and then probably sneakers for the plane. If you're bringing a dress, which is something that I'm doing, make sure that you can combine them with 1 or 2 of the jackets that you're bringing. And if it's gonna be cold, bring some tights or pantyhose. Don't forget to pack your accessories, which I haven't done because I'm procrastinating. And depending on the weather, you might need some additional outerwear. So for example, a raincoat, maybe some gloves, an umbrella, or a scarf. Be sure to pack a bag as well, because you'll probably be getting a lot of different papers and agendas and business cards, and you wanna keep that somewhere. I tend to bring my bigger bag, especially if I'm bringing my laptop. It tends to be a little bit easier for storing papers. Bring a file as well, and make sure you're bringing pens and pencils. You'd be surprised how many times people ask me to borrow a pen when you're at a conference. What are you doing at a conference without a pen? But if you're not bringing your laptop and you're not expecting to get a whole lot of paperwork, then you can definitely bring something that's on the smaller side. Be sure to bring some sort of notebook or notepad. This is my personal favorite, bullet journal. I'm really bad at this for some reason. I don't know why, but bring your glasses if you wear them. I've shown up a couple times to conferences where I can't see the screen very well, and doing this the whole time is not very pretty. And lastly, get a stack of your business cards and put them everywhere so you always have easy access to them. I can't even tell you how many places I have business cards. I haven't used this bag in several months, but I have business cards in here. In my journal, there's a little secret compartment, and I keep business cards in there as well. And I also have business cards in my wallet in case I'm out somewhere without my giant bag. Business cards everywhere. There's no excuse to write your name on a sticky note. None of that crap. Extra pro tip for you at the end, if you want to go above and beyond, print the agenda and the speaker bios ahead of time so you can review them on the flight and plan out what you're going to be doing at the conference. So there's your packing list for a 5-day conference or business trip. Let me know if I missed anything in the comments below. And if you did like the video, hit that thumbs up button and let me know in the comments so that I know to produce more of these types of videos. Alright, I'll talk to you guys later.